Hi everyone and welcome to another video. This one is about the Lenovo P50 laptop. During this video, we'll take a quick look at this laptop on the outside, inside and how it's performing. This P50 here has been my workhorse for the last 2.5 years. The P-series laptops were meant to be powerful mobile workstations. The non-S or slim version like this one, although still mobile, comes nowhere near something like a NX1 for example. The laptop is pretty bulky and heavy, but in return you do get a lot of performance and expandability, which you will see further in the video. As you can see, the P50 could even be equipped with a Xeon CPU and up to 64GB of RAM. The model I have has a bit more modest specifications. The CPU is an Intel Core i7-6820HQ with 4 cores. It has 16GB of DDR4, a 512GB NVMe SSD, and a 15.6-inch 4K screen that is connected to an NVIDIA Quadro M1000M. Let's have a look at the outside first. On the left side, you can see a built-in smart card reader, an express card slot, and SD card reader under that. On the right side, we can find an audio jack, 2 USB ports, mini display port, and a Kensington lock. The rest of the connectors are on the back of the laptop, 2 more USB ports, network, USB-C, HDMI, and the power connector. The 170 watt power supply for that is in the same fashion of the laptop, pretty bulky. After opening the laptop, we can find the webcam on top, the keyboard with numpad, track point, touchpad, color sensor and the fingerprint reader. I'll cover that color sensor in a bit more detail further in the video. The keyboard is pretty good, it's very comfortable to type on and never gives you the feeling that you're actually working on a laptop. The laptop isn't very small, but in return you do get a full numpad as well. The touchpad works okay, but over time mine started to have issues with multi-touch. Two-finger scrolling became a real pain to use. Not sure if it's a generic issue or just something with my specific device. About the track point, I can be short. As far as I can tell, it works fine, but I'm not a fan of it, so can't really tell much more than just that. You might have noticed as well that the laptop also has a hard disk LED. Apparently, this was a popular request since Lenovo had removed it on earlier models. Personally, I'm not really a fan of that as it kind of distracts and it's pretty useless with a fast SSD. Time to turn around the laptop and go a bit deeper. Let's first remove the 90 watt hour battery. Then we can remove the 6 screws that hold the bottom cover in place and get access to the internals. As you can see, the cover doesn't come off very fluently and requires a bit of wiggling. On first sight, it looks a bit boring and empty here, but that only shows how much options there are for expansion. I did see that everything looks pretty dusty on the video footage, not that visible in real life, but it's definitely time to clean up the laptop a bit better. We have 2 additional slots for memory, covered under a protective foil. Two M.2 slots for NVMe drives, with one installed, and also room for a SATA drive. After removing the SSD, you can see it's in a plastic enclosure, which is the same one for the other slot as well. Let's put that back before we continue. The rest is located under the keyboard. To get access to that, we need to first remove some additional screws holding it in place. Then we can flip the laptop over. The keyboard needs to be moved to the back a bit. And then can be carefully taken out. Under here we can find the additional RAM slots below a metal shield. We We have 2x8GB installed for a total of 16GB in dual channel. Together with the slots on the back, this means the laptop has 4 slots in total, pure luxury. The Wi-Fi and Bluetooth card can also be found here. Before putting back the keyboard, don't forget to reinstall the shielding and get it fixed. Been there, done that. Then, to close up everything again, we can put back the keyboard and slide it back in place. And get it fixed. Now we can put back the back cover and fix that as well. And finally, reinstall the battery. In the BIOS setup, we can see what we already knew. The i7 CPU is listed here and the 16GB of RAM. Once the laptop is booted into Windows, we can have a look at the software part. In Device Manager, we can see the NVIDIA Quadro, the SSD, and the CPU. Time to have a look at performance. Let's run the CPU benchmark in Geekbench 5. Not too bad here for a laptop, and keep in mind that this one is from beginning 2015. I did run the same test before on battery, and although it was set to best performance, the score was a lot less. Maybe this is something that can be tuned in the BIOS, although I didn't see anything related at first glance. It's definitely something to keep in mind. Let us also see how that Quadro is performing. $9,850. As expected, I would say. Not amazing, but keep in mind that this laptop is not the most recent either. Last benchmark is for disk performance. Too quick, very good sign already. Let me set the test file size a bit larger and redo the test. Very nice speeds here. This performance won't be your bottleneck on this laptop. Last thing I'd like to show is about the color sensor on the laptop. This sensor allows you to color calibrate the screen. To do so, we need to install a small tool, the Pantone Color Calibrator, which is available to download from Lenovo's website. After launching that tool, we get clear instructions on how this works. We need to set the brightness to a good level, then close the laptop lid and let the tool do its magic. During the process, the LED on the top of the laptop will update us about the progress. Unfortunately, the footage on how this looks like on camera has gone missing. During the process, different colors are shown on the screen and the sensor will measure how they are displayed. In the end, the color profile will be adapted to the measurements from the sensor, and the displayed colors on the screen should be accurate. Not sure if this really works in a reliable way, but still a nice idea and cool feature. That was it for this short overview of the Lenovo P50. Hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please put a thumbs up. If you like this kind of content, don't hesitate to subscribe to my channel for more of the same. Thanks again, and hope to see you back here soon.